More now on the COVID situation in Victoria. Let's bring in former president of the AMA and GP, Dr. Mukesh Haikerwal in Melbourne. Mukesh, good morning to you. Daily cases surging past 2,000, 2,297, I think, is the exact figure. But what's behind this, do you think?
The concern is that we've done a hell of a lot of work trying to get the numbers down. And despite all of our efforts, they have still continued to go up. And I think it's a combination of the vaccination not getting to where it needs to get to in some parts of the city and now lighting up as being red areas. We're also seeing people who are tiring and just letting their guard down and gathering in places where they shouldn't be. And it's really a matter of not doing that for a couple of more weeks. We'll be at the top of the peak in a couple of weeks. So once we get there, these numbers will start to drop. So it's a combination of just keeping our guard up, all the work we've done of 270, 280 days in isolation, in a lockdown, the whole thing about being the most lockdown city in the world. It's really kept the most important thing, people keeping out of hospital, keeping off ventilators, and people who have to go to hospital walking out. We've carried on doing that, and that's what we're going to carry on doing. The numbers are going up. It's startling. In fact, it's very upsetting yesterday. I would have been extraordinarily upset this morning because of, you know, how bad it makes us feel. But some good things have happened, like Captain Kirk has broken the final frontier and gone into space, so that's wonderful.
Good distraction at least, Mukesh. Having said that, and I feel for Melbourne, you know, so many months in lockdown, has the state of Victoria reached its peak, though?
We're expecting the peak to be in a week or so. That'll be when we will see the benefits of the vaccination. And, you know, we've really gone hammer and tong with the vaccinations. In my city here, we were ground zero. We've worked in the badminton centre nearby. We've taken over Witten Oval with Western Health. We've worked with Western Bulldogs. We've brought the communities, all the communities in our area together. It's happened in Hume, in the north of the city. And what we're seeing now is that other areas that were kind of relaxed about it, thinking that they weren't exposed, are now getting exposed. We're going to see this in other states. We're going to see this in Queensland, where the numbers are going to start to increase, unfortunately, if people aren't getting vaccinated. So the key message is, if you cut your finger, you wouldn't think twice about getting a tetanus. That's a vaccine. If you were going to Bali, you wouldn't think twice about getting travel vaccines for typhoid or for hepatitis B. You would not do that. And if you're going to go into work in health, you wouldn't think twice about getting vaccinated about hepatitis B, which is the life-threatening disease. So this is all the same. You know, COVID does exist. The sun, the world is round. If the sun rises in the east and sets in the west, these are all given. If you don't believe it, that's your problem. But for goodness sake, the rest of us who are sensible, let's do the right thing.
Yeah, you are a wise man, Doctor. Hey, despite high cases, Victoria will open next week. Dan Andrews saying, and I quote, "We have a really important agreement with the community. You get vaccinated and we open up." But it's a big but, isn't it? We have a serious situation in the state's hospitals. You've got to be worried about that.
Yes, indeed. And so the hospitals, we don't want the situation overseas where every single ward is a COVID ward and then somebody with a heart attack can't get in, or somebody with a stroke can't get in, or somebody who needs surgery for cancer can't get in. So that's what the effort has been around since last year. This is why the 230 plus days of being locked down has paid its dividend. This is hard work of good Victorian people doing the right thing. We just need to keep our guard up, and we must try and keep those people out of hospital for COVID so the hospitals can be used for people who actually need other things other than COVID. You know, we are working in COVID wards. You know, my son worked in a COVID ward. You know, we all get really worried for our people there, and we're doing the best we can to keep people safe. Please do your own best of this. Get vaccinated, get tested, and make sure you keep yourself well and out of hospital if you can.
Yeah, the strain is showing on everyone, including you, Mukesh. Thank you so much for all your hard work and your expertise. Thanks for coming on this morning, Ali.